Hello dear students, welcome to Axiomaticos. This video is the part of the solution series for IIT JAM 2012. So we are here with this problem 15 of your paper. This problem is a problem of vector calculus. So let us have a look. If C is a smooth curve in R cube from 0, 0, 0 to 2, 1, -1, then the value of. So we have to evaluate this line integral over this curve C. Now what important thing to notice here is that the curve C is not given to us. Are you getting my point or not? So if I will draw a 3D plane over here, let me draw it over here. So for this 3D plane, you know the initial point, right? You know your initial point. So this is 0, 0, 0. And let us say this is 2, 1 and minus 1, right? Now what do you know that C is a curve from here to here, which is a smooth, right? But you don't know what C is. So what's the problem with the question? When you deal with the line integral, then the most important thing to solve that line integral is the curve itself. If you don't know the curve, then it's very difficult to solve, okay, almost impossible. So what important thing is here to introduce the concept of conservative vector fields. So what are conservative vector fields? We are going to have a look on that. So see over here, what do you have? You have this line integral. Let me represent this line integral as I. So what is your line integral? It's 2xy plus z dx plus z plus x square dy plus x plus y dz. So this is your line integral, right? Now what you can write, you can write this as f vector dot dr, where f vector will be what? 2xy plus z, right, dx plus I've written a wrong statement. Okay, 2xy plus z, I should write I over here, okay, plus z plus x square j plus x plus y k, right? So this is your f. What is dr over here? Dr is this thing. Dr vector is dxi plus dyj plus dzk. Now what we have to figure out, we have to show that this f vector, that the force field that we have, is a conservative vector field. And why it is so important to show it's a conservative vector field, we will have it, okay? So firstly, what I will do, I will just state what is a vector, conservative vector field. So if we have a scalar function phi such that f vector that we have can be written as gradient of that scalar field, then we say that this vector field f is a conservative vector field, okay? And why it is important, we will do this later. So now see, if you will consider this as your vector field, okay, do you know the meaning of this gradient of phi? It's del phi over del x I plus del phi over del y z plus del phi over del z k. This is the meaning of conservative vector field. So right now what I am doing, I am just guessing what will be. So you need phi such that its partial derivative with respect to x should be 2xy plus z, partial derivative with respect to y should be z plus x square, partial derivative with respect to z should be x plus y, right? So this is what you need. So what we need to firstly do, we need to firstly think of a guess, okay? So see, if you need this 2xy when you have differentiated it partially with respect to x, then it means that you need x square y. Are you getting my point or not? So I should write it over here. I will write phi over here. So you got my point that I need x square y. Why I need x square y? Because on differentiating partially with respect to x, I am getting 2xy, and partially with respect to y, I am getting x square. Now the problem of z is there. So what I need to include is zx, because if you will differentiate it partially with respect to x, you will get this z. And if you differentiate partially with respect to y, you will not get z over here because you will get 0 because both are the constant functions. So that means you need to also include zy over there, right? Because including. So using this phi scalar function, we can get f, right? So from here we can prove that we have proved that, okay, we cannot, we have proved that f is a conservative vector field. Now what happens for a conservative vector field? That if you integrate it over any curve, let us say C, then it depends upon only the initial and final point. So what you do here is actually del phi dot dr, and you can write this as phi, just the initial and final point. Are you getting my point? So finally you got that why conservative vector field is so important here, because in this case you don't need any path, you can do it over every path that joins 0, 0, 0 and 2, 1, minus 1. So what is your phi now? So x square y plus zx plus zy, right? And what are the initial point? It's 0, 0, 0 and it's 2, 1, minus 1. Now just place these value over here. What you will get? You will get, I think, 4. Then you will get minus 2, then you will get plus, 4, 2, okay, so then you will get minus 1 over here, right? So finally, you got your 1 as your answer. So what I have done so far is the first thing that to show whether F is a conservative vector field or not. Once you show that F is a conservative vector field, then you don't need any such path like this one. Are you getting my point? You can directly talk with this scalar function and the initial and final point. So this is the result that we have to use here in order to solve this question, right? So now let us mark the correct options. C is correct, B is incorrect, A is incorrect, and D is also incorrect, right? So thank you.